My name is Anne-Marie Wijmans and I'm a researcher at the University of St. Andrews. I'm an astronomer and I'm here to answer your questions about space. And last week I got really so many really good questions from all of you about space that I unfortunately don't have time to answer all of them. So I've selected three and those are the three that I'm going to answer. But if you listen very carefully, you may notice that I sneaked in a few other questions that I will answer. So okay, let's get started here. Okay, so here's the first question I got, and it's a question from Mary, and she asks, apart from stars and planets, what else is in space? And I think this is an incredible good question to start with, because it allows me to show you lots of pretty pictures of what is actually in space. And if we start with answering this question quite close to home, in our own solar system. So the solar system, that means that's the sun, that is our star, and the eight planets, of which Earth is one. So if you then see what else is there, well, there is the moon. Earth has a moon, but the other planets also have moons. And here's a picture of four of the biggest moons of Jupiter. Jupiter is a really big planet and it has lots of moons. It has more than 75 moons. But these four moons, I think, are the prettiest. And I especially like the moon on the left here. That moon is called Io, and it is a moon that has actual real volcanoes on it. But these are just four of them. There are many more moons in the solar system, and you should definitely look them up if you are interested in that. Now, what we else have in our own solar system is some smaller rocks. When I say small, I still mean several kilometers, maybe even 100 kilometers across, but small compared to planets. And these are things like meteoroids and asteroids and also comets. And here I want to show you a very famous comet. This is Halley's Comet. And it's named after Halley because he's the astronomer who first predicted that comets actually go around the sun and therefore come back to Earth every so often. And Halley's Comet is a comet that is coming back to Earth every 75 years. And now let me quickly look at my notes, because the next time that Halley's Comet is coming back is in 2061. So you know what to look out for there. Now, if we leave our own solar system and we're going out further in the Milky Way, our galaxy, to see at other stars, what I always find very spectacular is stellar nurseries. So stars are formed from gas. So if you have a place in the Milky Way where there's lots of gas, you can start forming stars. And one of those places is Orion's Nebula. And I really love this nebula because it's so incredibly pretty. And what is going on here is that there is gas that is still forming stars. And this nebula is located in the constellation of Orion. So if it's a very clear night, it's a bit difficult. You can see it with the naked eye, but it's maybe more helpful if you also have some binoculars to look at it. Now, we have these star-forming nebula. But stars can also be very, very pretty if they, and this sounds a bit sad, but when they die. So a star shines because it's filled with gas, with hydrogen gas, and then it converts that into helium gas. But at some point, the star will run out of hydrogen gas, and that's the end of its life. So our sun still has 10 billion years of gas to keep shining, so don't worry about that. But some other stars have already reached the end of their life. And what they then do, well, you get a bit of fireworks. So here's an example of what a star looks like when it has reached the end of its life. And this star was a small star, so a star comparable to the sun. And at the end of its life, the star did poof. And it just ejected all the outer layers of the star that are made out of gas into space. And those started to shine. And we call this a planetary nebula. And that is a really, really stupid name. But it is because when first astronomers started to look at these things through telescopes, they looked a bit like planets. And only later on we discovered they're not planets. They're actually dying stars. And this particular one is called the Cat's Eye Nebula. And yeah, it does look a little bit like a cat's eye. But this is for the smaller stars. What happens when a really, really big star, so think 10 times as massive as the sun, when they reach the end of their life? They don't go poof, they go boom. They really explode, and that's what we call a supernova. And this picture here shows you what then is left over from the star. The star has exploded, all the gas that was left is going into space, and this nebula here is called the Crab Nebula. And I will admit, this one is a bit more difficult to see. I'm not quite sure why people thought there is a crab in this nebula. But anyway, maybe you can discover it. Now, what is really interesting about these really, really massive stars is what then happens next to that star, because it has exploded, but the core of the star is still there. And in the Crab Nebula, it's maybe not really easy to see, but there's a tiny, tiny star left that is spinning really, really fast, and that is called a pulsar. But if you have a star that is really, really massive, then the supernova explosion is so incredibly big that the star collapses on itself, and then you get a black hole. And I know we all want to know more about black holes, right? That's a whole different set of questions that people have there. But that is how you form a black hole. It's basically a really, really heavy star that explodes at the end of its life. And I'm now, even though I'm only allowed 3 questions, I'm gonna answer Sophie's question, who asked, what is the difference between a black hole and a supermassive black hole? Because talking about black holes, these black holes caused by exploding stars are not the only ones around. In the center of our Milky Way and in the center of most other galaxies, you will find a supermassive black hole. And a supermassive black hole is, as the name says, super, super massive. It's as heavy as millions and millions, sometimes even billions of stars. Now, the supermassive black hole in our Milky Way is very far away from us, so we don't need to worry about falling in. But there are some great movies where you can see some of the stars in the center of the Milky Way floating around. And there's a link here to one of those movies if you want to look at those. Okay, so I hope that answered your question, Mary, about what is out there in space.